are your relatives, close friends, and you will see a huge change in your atmosphere, particularly if you are playing the YouTube channel, you know, continuously. And, you know, you can put a topic in the search bar, and you can put a specific topic, and many prayers and messages can come up for that particular situation. And you just pray along with her, because people will say, oh, you know, I need to get in touch with her. The way this ministry works, the woman of God is online with services 3 times per week. And then she's making sure to get these messages posted. She's praying for the entire world. So that's why we come together, because there's a power when we come in the presence and we are in one spirit and one accord and we are praying alongside His woman servant. That is where all the angels get released. The power comes down from on high. So you just continue to avail yourself of all that is there for God's people to tap in. And you will be blessed, you and your family.
Yeah, one question. What time, I'm in Massachusetts, what time does she come in the morning?
Okay, we are on 12 noon on Sundays, and then 6 a.m. on Wednesday we begin, and 6 a.m. on Friday. And on Friday, what we do is we come on, and the beginning of the service is just all of us for corporate prayer. We're just opening our mouth. We're just getting the atmosphere stirred. We're praying for the ministry. We're praying for His woman servant. And we're ushering in, you know, the presence of the Holy Spirit and just taking that time to acknowledge Him. And then we begin. And the beauty of what God does through Apostle is that we never know what the Holy Spirit is going to do. She does not pre-plan messages. She does not prepare sermons. She doesn't write anything out. Whatever He tells her to do, like today, He commanded her to pray for God's people to release the healing power. Another day we might come on, we might have some word and teaching of the word. We might have a time of, you know, testimony and a portion, all different things that the Lord will do. That's what's so exciting about this ministry, because the Holy Spirit runs the agenda, not even her and not man. And also on Fridays, we set aside time in that service is for deliverance, specifically for the digging out of roots, the destroying of altars, and for God's people to be delivered from captivity. Again, it's
Thank
not
you.
A call out, but believe me, you just pray, Lord, locate me. And even if the person's name isn't called out on Friday, we can, while she's praying for someone else, you might have an identical situation. You can receive that deliverance prayer as well. So glory to God, and we welcome you, Sister Eve, in the midst. and she was claiming it, and I was claiming long life. She said, prophesy over your life. I was claiming long life for her, and crown of her head to the soles of her feet, and she received it all. So I am so grateful to God for using his woman servant. You know, the amount of virtue that it takes, the way she prays, she's totally anointed and equipped for it. Believe me, she is. I'm just saying that the amount of virtue and what it takes to, as she just pushes, and she went to the third heaven to grab for God's people, body parts, to call down that healing manifestation over people's lives. That is nothing to play with, because I'm telling you, she's piercing principalities and powers to get what God's people need to have full and joyful and productive lives. Because what does he say in 1 John 3, verse 2? Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. She's praying for that double balance. She's praying for that soul to prosper so that it permeates to the physical. And there's that joining, there's that crossing over of the spiritual touching the physical. So people of God, I have to tell you, that rhema wind, I stood up a few times and I was moving around, and it literally was knocking me down, like back towards a chair, knocking me back. It was so forceful. And people would say, blowing in a phone? Let me tell you, people of God, we're not looking at the natural device of the phone. We're looking at the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes. The atmosphere to reach God's people. We're all in different places right now connected on this phone. Some in Massachusetts, some in the Caribbean, some in England, some in Carolina. All different places. But you know what? And if we are right here together, and that spirit was so strong, and all the angels, you could feel the brush of the angels' wings as she was praying. All the angels that work for her are working for us. Right there.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Anyone
else that would like to say something? Don't want to leave anyone out before we were to close out the service. I always make sure that everyone has had an opportunity. Now,
this is Sister Eva.
Yes, Mother Yvonne.
God bless. I give God praise, glory, and honor. I thank God for today, though, and every day that the Lord has given this woman of God. Just as a powerful force, and I know it's from God. I thank God because every one of God starts praying for each and everything in our body all over. I just have to receive quite a many things. I remember I went to the doctor the last time. They were telling me, like, I have bronchitis. They're telling me all these different things that as a woman of God keep calling these names, that the Holy Spirit, you learn to call out these names and many things. I have to just go and receive pneumonia. Everything I have to receive and claim it. And God is really doing this, man of God. And I start remembering. You know, God is really good in that. God brings my mind to my memory.
Amen.
He said, claim it for your family. And it's like I start remembering going back to some of my relatives, in-laws. Some of them with these kind of sickness. A lot of people in our family, relatives, close friends, have this kind of sickness. We're not even thinking about them. What did God just start bringing these people back to my memory?
Right.
I'm praying for these people. Claiming for people who not, I don't even know the things that they are going through. And I know have that sickness. And I say, I thank God for what she comes for today. The way the Lord uses her. And it's just to make herself available. It's up to be us. No one but Jesus. All about Jesus. And I thank God for what God is doing in our life. And each and every one of us come together. Let us just think that she always said, do not give me the glory. She always stressed that. Give it to God. And as that
yes.
Her. And we have to continue to ask God to bless her and keep this woman going. Because he's the one that is in her life. And she's not. I just thank God for what he's doing. And may God bless each and every one of you. We all have a story to tell. Whatever it is, we have a story. God give us something, whether we have to go through. Sometimes you see we go through a lot of things going on in our lives. It's just for the glory of God.
Yes.
Teach me that. I didn't know all these things. It's for the glory of God. And we go through a hard time in your life.
Jesus Christ. Wherever he is, as you stand in my God Almighty agreement for him, Rabakatoria Masonde. I command for my God Almighty the Rhema wind of God right now to consume that my God Almighty strokes from off his body. And whoever is having a stroke, may the Rhema wind of God consume it right now. Right now in Jesus' name. My God Almighty, may you tell him about this. May he able to tune in. May he able to tune in on this day where we have this testimony. May he able to tune in on it and claim it even more. In Remiosha Mama Kotoria Maseke, I speak healing, miracles, signs, and wonder over him in Jesus' name, and everyone else in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. All glory and honor to your name. Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.